This video is brought to you by trendmicro's Cleaner One Pro. So we're kicking off 2023 with a list of cool Mac apps worth sinking your teeth into, and to set the vibes just right, I shall waste no time and open up the first app called Poolsuite FM to set the mood. Poolsuite FM is an internet radio station that has started as a retro-inspired website, which now has an official Mac app. The music they can find on Poolsuite is described as an infinity pool of summer sounds, which, let's be honest, all of us need. It's a very minimal looking app that reminds me a lot of Winamp, which, if you know what it is, means that you are a millennial. It's free to use and it has some nifty tools like an easily accessible AirPlay controls for dispersing the music. And if you like a track that's playing, you can click on the name to open it in SoundCloud for easy sharing. And by the way, the app is based on SoundCloud. The next app that I recently started playing with is called Dropover, and you can think of it as a drag and drop utility. Once installed, the app stays hidden in the menu bar, ready to be triggered by grabbing something and shaking the mouse. By doing that, you're summoning a Dropover floating shelf to place things into. You can use this app to gather all sorts of information into one temporary place. It works with any content, not only local Finder files. You can select images from browser or even highlight text. The app comes in very handy if you're trying to organize files that are scattered all over the computer or simply collect online materials. Once you have your items placed on the shelf, you can move them to the desired location or use the menu to take all sorts of actions like creating an iCloud link, for example, and my most used one, sending whatever I have placed on the shelf via AirDrop. Very inconspicuous and useful app that costs as much as a coffee. While on the topic of grabbing things and overall organization, another app that I rely on after every single video project of mine is trendmicro's Cleaner One Pro. It is an all-in-one disk cleaning manager that helps me visualize, manage, and free up storage space with one click thanks to the smart scanner feature. Two other features that matter to me a lot are the disk map and app manager. Disk map helps me find out whatever is taking up most of my disk space, and the app manager helps me uninstall apps the proper way, without leaving a trace of additional library or other files. The built-in toolbar monitors my computer performance and traffic, which also comes in handy when I put my Mac to its paces while transcoding and exporting. The app has a lot more features worth exploring, like managing your startup apps and finding duplicate files. So if you want to keep your Mac in order, head over to the first link in the description below and install trendmicro's Cleaner One Pro for free. Next up is Xnip. Xnip? I'm not sure. What's the pronunciation? I use an older Safari page screenshot app, but I can't always rely on it if you want to take a screenshot of websites that load and scroll. With Xnip, I can take a full or partial page screenshot based on my scrolling behavior. Another reason to pay attention to this app is the simple yet very powerful annotation capabilities, much easier than the built-in ones in preview, mainly because they have less friction when using them. Another reason I switched to this app is the pixel-perfect screenshot preview pane, which helps me grab the most accurate screenshot, which might seem a bit excessive to some people, but I can appreciate the time that I save in the image editing later. Xnip lives in the menu bar and can be acquired via a subscription or a one-time fee for people like me who are more than happy with what they currently see in the app as far as features. The next app is called Balance, and it's a time-tracking app with a focus on work-life balance. It's a very well-designed app that you can use to manually clock in and out of sessions. The manual aspect is on purpose to help you mentally detach when not working. The app features break reminders and weekly summaries, as well as a focus feature for people who are into the Pomodoro technique. I've been using Balance for a while to track my different tasks as I try to optimize them as much as possible, and also to get the occasional break since I tend to go overboard once I sit in front of the computer. By the way, all the app links that we talk about will be linked in the description below, and if you end up enjoying this video, subscribe, because why not? The next app is called HiddenBar, and it's a free alternative to Bartender. It basically helps you take control of the huge list of apps that you keep in the menu bar in the simplest way possible. It's a simple separator app that works by dragging the vertical line to the position where it will hide everything to the left while keeping everything to the right visible. Come to think of it, one downside of the app compared to the more expensive alternatives is that you need to rearrange all the menu items so that all the ones you want to keep visible stay to the right of the hidden bar divider, which is not a big deal, and in most cases it's a one-time job. By the way, if you want to know how to arrange the menu bar items, you can hold the command and use the mouse to move them around. Next, if you have a mouse that has additional buttons but doesn't have native macOS support, meaning you cannot remap those buttons, you can get an app called Better Touch Tool to remap those buttons. With this app, you can program and customize various input devices, from the Magic Mouse keyboard all the way to the Steam Deck, or Stream Deck. In my case, I wanted to bypass the Logitech G Hub software to customize my G502 mouse and simply remap two of these side keys to move between my desktop spaces. Another application I found for this tool is for my Keychron K3 Pro keyboard, which for some reason doesn't change the studio brightness levels unless I simulate an F1 press with function in F1. With Better Touch Tool, I can now use my brightness controls as intended. Speediness is a simple yet very convenient speed test app for the Mac. Instead of each time going to the browser and, you know, speedtest.net or something else, Speediness is just a tap away. By default, the app runs tests in parallel to better reflect the real-world situations rather than displaying the optimal result. For that reason, if you compare Speediness with another tool, you might witness results that differ from each other, but I'd go for Speediness. Rocket is a cool emoji app that can help you spice up any text, description, email, or chat. The app is invisible, and if you want to trigger, just type column and start tapping the emoji that you're looking for. I don't know of a faster way to summon emoji, to be honest. What's even better is that it's absolutely free. HomeControl menu for HomeKit is the little menu helper that I use to summon HomeKit scenes and most of all integrate with my Home Studio Elgato Stream Deck. Aside from saving time from having to open the Home app, HomeControl gives you unique scenes links that you can use to paste in the Stream Deck to use it as a scenes trigger, something that I use all the time in my Home Studio. By the way, if you're interested to know more about my Home Studio desk setup, I'll be sure to place a link at the end of this video. In my recent favorite iPad apps video, which I'll link in the description below, I talked about an app called Noir, which I relish for its ability to transform every website into a dark mode version. Even though Noir is now officially released on the Mac, I started using an alternative called Dark Reader for Safari. Now, I know this is not a traditional app per se, but rather an extension. Still, it is worth exploring, especially if you work during the dark hours of the day and want to reduce the stress on your eyes. What's great about Dark Reader is the ability to use it for PDF files that are displayed within the browser too. Now, let's move on to some creative apps. Mockview app is something that I discovered very recently. With it, I can create Apple device mockups in both 2D and 3D. If you want to test how a design mockup might look on an iPhone or how a wallpaper might render on a tablet, this is a great tool for that. You can use it to showcase projects to clients and impress them with gorgeous visuals. You simply have to drop your image in the app and position it relative to the screen size that you have chosen. Once that's ready, in the 2D option, you can even add gradients or custom backgrounds, and if you choose 3D, you can create all sorts of angles that you can export as transparent PNGs to apply in presentation, or in my case, videos. The next creative app is for people who often require placeholder text for visual purposes, something that is often referred to as lorem ipsum. If you are a designer, for example, GetIpsum is a tiny app that saves a lot of time. It lives in the menu bar. And once you trigger it, all you have to do is hover and select with your mouse the amount of lorem ipsum text that you require. From the settings, you can choose if you want the text to appear as plain text or HTML and even change the dictionary. Let's say you're in a meeting and you're sharing your screen and suddenly you start getting messages that everyone can see. The quickest way to trigger Do Not Disturb mode is to head over to the clock and while holding the Option key, click on the clock and that immediately turns on Do Not Disturb. The other people wouldn't even realize what's happening. That's one of the hidden tips that I discuss in my macOS option tips I should have known video, which you can check out right here. Like and subscribe to the channel as well as my newsletter. And as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is Z, over and out.